Hi, do you want to learn how to make food flyers or you're interested in learning graphic design? Then this video is for you. In this video, I'll be taking you through the step-by-step process which you need in order to become a professional graphic designer. So if this is what you want, then stay tuned while I take you through my laptop and I'll be teaching you a whole lot of things. In food graphic design, there are things you need to know, which is you must make your flyers attractable so that your customers can be able to buy from you. And that is what I'll be teaching you how to do today. So if this is what you want, stay tuned. And don't forget, my name is Elijah Comfort. Thank you.
Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Give it a thumbs up.
To design a food flyer, you have to create your workspace, and that is what we are going to do now. So we are going to make our width to be 8.307 and our height will be 11.693, and then the resolution will be 300. Make sure it's in inches because we are measuring in inches, and our color mode would be RGB color, because the reason why it's RGB color is because is not a printer, is not, we don't want to print it. It's actually for a social media purpose. So when you're making designs that are for social media purpose, you use RGB color, then you click on create. Once you click on create, this workspace will come out. So the first thing we are going to do now is to set up our background. So for us to set up the background, we have to use, we have to come here, come to this down, you click on it, then you scroll up and go to gradients. You click on your gradients, then you click here. You can choose any of these and then change the color. So let me choose this. So I'll click here and change the color. So I'll be showing you the color code I used. The color code I used is B01004. That's the color code I use. This is the color code in case if you want to recreate this design. Then you click on here and also change this. So I will probably show you the color code I used for this one. So this is it. This is the color code I used. Okay. Then you come here. I want to. Then you click on OK. Then you come here. The angle which we are using is 90. Then the scale. Let's change the scale to 44. I think this is now okay. Then let's make it to be, the style will be in radical. Then let's make it reverse. Yeah, I think this is what we want. With this, I think we are good to go. Then you click on okay. So the next thing we are going to do now is to draw our triangle. There are so many other ways to do that, but then I just want to use this. Click on your rectangular tool. Click on the rectangular tool and you can go ahead and draw. Let's draw this way. So let's change the color here. I want it to be not really white, but something, a kind of white, because we'll be power clicking. We'll be adding an image to it. So then you click here and let's rotate it. As I said before, there are so many ways we can actually do this, but I think this is one of the simplest way we do it. So then we click on OK. Then make sure you're selecting this rectangle, then you go to where your image is and select the particular image you'll be using for this design. So I'm going to show you my image. I save all my image under documents. So that is what I'll be going to bring now. This is the image I used there. So I'll just click on it and drag it to my Photoshop. Once you drag it to Photoshop, you bring it here. So I'm going to make it bigger. So I'll click here, then I'll come to the layer and then right click on it, and then I'll click on this create a clipping mask. It will fit in just the way we want it to be. Once you do that, it will just fit in perfectly and we are good to go. So the next thing I'll do now is I want it to have something white here, so I'll just click on my triangle. There are other ways you can do it, by adding a stroke to this triangle, but I don't want to use that method because I will still have to work on the line. Okay, so that is why I don't want to use the method. So this is it. I want to draw the triangle myself so that if I want to make some kind of changes on it, I can actually do that. So then I'll click here and change the color. I want it to be white. I want it to be pure white. So I'm going to change the white here. So then I'll rotate it. So this is it. I've added a white to it. But then I want the white to have a stroke, so I'm going to double click on the layer, then go to here, drop down shadow. I want it to have a shadow. But then I want this white to have a something like a drop down shadow, so I'll just right click, I'll double click on the layer, then come here, I'll click on drop down shadow, and let me increase the shadow. I want it to be pure black. So this is it. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to bring in my circles. Okay, I want to bring in some circles that I'm going to upload on. So now I want to bring in my circles, so I'll just come here, click on Windows, because I want to close this. I want to bring out some rulers that I will use to align my work. So in case yours doesn't have the rulers here, you just come and cancel your tool so that it will show you. But if you already have your ruler here, there is no need of you coming here. So this is just it. My tool is there. So I'll just drag one of the rulers. I want it to guide me in drawing my circle. So I really want it to help me in drawing my circle, but then I want to also put a ruler that can help us in guiding all our work. Okay, so for you to do that, always do that on all your work so that you can align it properly. So I'll just come here, I'll click on view, I'll scroll down. You see a place they wrote new guide layout, then you click on this new guide layout. And then you can resize it to whatever you want here to be. But me, I think I'm okay with this. So I'll just click on. Okay. I'll just click on. Okay. So which is very fine. So now I have my. I think I need to change the. So for me to put a guideline, I think this guideline I put, they are too small, so I won't increase it. I'll go to view, still scroll down to new guide layout, and I want to change everything to, let's say, 2.4. So this is it now. The next thing I'm going to do is to draw a circle. So I'll just click on this and select my lasso tool. Some people call it your circle tool, but then what is always written on Photoshop is lasso tool. So you click on it, and before you can do that, just click here. Click on the main layer. Don't select this. So you come here, you click here, you select your lasso tool. Then for you to draw a very perfect circle, what you do is you hold your shift and you draw. You hold your shift and you draw. You see it? When you hold your shift and draw, it helps you to get the perfect shape of circle. So now I'm going to change the color. I'll come here and change the color. So, and I want to give it a stroke. The color of the stroke, I want it to be white. So I'll click on OK. And I'll change here to, I don't want it to be 12. Yeah, 7. I think 7 should be okay. 7 should be okay. So this is it. 7. Let me still increase it to about 10. I think this should be okay. So now I'm going to select this circle. I want to duplicate it because I'll be using like 3 of it. So I'm going to duplicate it now into 3. So for you to do that, I'll just click Ctrl J, which means to duplicate. I've duplicated it into 3, and we bring the layer up so that it will be showing above this. So now we've placed the circles the way we just want them to be. The next thing we are going to do now is to add an image to it. And for us to do that, you just make sure you are selecting the particular circle you want to add an image to. Then you come here, you click and go and find the right image you want to use. As for this, I think let's use this particular image. You click on it and drag it to your Photoshop, and you bring it here. Let me resize it. Let me make it smaller. I think that will help. So now I've resized it. I'll go to the layer here. I will now right click on it and click on create a clipping mask. You see, once you click on create a clipping mask, the image will fit in just the way you want it to. So this is it, you click here and we are good to go. So I still want to increase the stroke here. I still want to increase it to 23. I think 23 is okay. Okay, let's just make it 30. Let's just type it in 30 here. So I think we are good to go. I will now click on the second image and still do the same thing. I'll just come here, get the right image I want to use. Let's use this, click on it, drag it to my Photoshop, and here, then I'll resize it to however I want it to be, and then click here, and I'll come to this layer and click by the side, create a clipping mask. It will fit in properly. As you can see, it did. So now let me also increase this to 30. I want to also increase the stroke, all of them. I want to make it 30 so that it will just be the same. So this, I'll do the same thing for the last image we have here. So let's click here, let's use this image, drag it to my Photoshop, resize it so that it will fit in just the way I want it. And always remember to click on this arrow up, then you come by the side, click on it, right click on it, and then click on create a clipping mask. So I'll come here, I'll increase it to 30 just as I did for the other one. So the next thing we'll be doing now is I want us to add some image to it. But before we do that, I want us to add some things. You know, food design, you have to make your food design to be something that once people look at it, they'll just feel like, oh, I wish I just have this food, I just want to eat it, you know, because that is the way you can convince your customers. They are not there, they haven't seen the food yet. So, but when your flyer is telling them that the food is yummy, they would like to have it. So that is why we are going to add some leaf just to spice things up. So because of that, I'll just click here, I'll just go get, click here and look for wherever I save it. So this is the leaf we are going to be making use of. You just click on it and then you take it to your Photoshop. This is it. So I'll just resize it to fit in perfectly the way we want it. So with this now, we'll just click on this arrow, but then I still want to add a bit of it more. I want to still add again. So I'll just, either you duplicate it or you bring it in again, whichever way is good is okay. So let me duplicate it. I click on Ctrl J to duplicate. So I will now resize the one I duplicated. I just want to resize it and know how it's going to look like. So let me rotate it. Let me change it either ways. Let me change it this way. Yeah. I think this is better. So let me make it a bit bigger. So as it is now, I don't want, it's not everything on it that I want, this particular one I duplicated, it's not everything on it, I don't want to see this part. So for me to remove that part, I'll just select it and right click on it. Then I'll come here, rasterize the layer, then I'll use this tool. This is a rectangular mask tool. I'll just click on it and I'll just select the ones I don't want to see. Any one of them that I don't want to see, I'll just select it. Anyone I don't just want to see, I'll just select it. I'll deselect by Ctrl D. I'll just clean them up. Once I select them, I'll delete. Once I select, I delete. Once I select, I delete. So once I'm done doing that, I'll click Ctrl D to deselect the places I've selected. So now we've fit in everything just the way we want it. I would like us to put a, but make sure you click here. So I would like us to add a call to action here. So for us to do that, you just come straight and let me click here. I don't want it to underneath anything, so I'll just scroll up and go to the first here and I'll click on my, on this. I'll go and select the rectangular tool. I'll select the rectangular tool because I want to add a call to action here. Something like this would not be a bad idea. I think this is okay by me. Then I want to change the color. I'll click here and I'll select color from the leaf. I want to use color from any of these leaves. Okay, I think it's not that. So I'm selecting this. This is the color code 094501. That's the color code. I'll click on OK. Then I'm going to click this. So I want to actually give it some kind of shape, you know, some kind of shape to make it look fancy. So I'll just come here, right click there, rasterize it, and I'll use this particular tool. This is polygonal lasso tool. Don't mind my pronunciation. So once I click on this tool, I'll come here, I'll click here and bring my hand towards the up. Click on it and bring it here too. Click on it. So I'm just select this area. Once I select this area, I'll click on delete. I'll click Ctrl D to deselect. So now we are good to go. I'll bring this down a bit. I don't want it to be that up, so I'm going to bring it down a bit. So I don't like the size, it's too long. So I'll hold my shift key and I'll reduce it from here. Yep, I think we are good to go now. So the next thing I want to type into it, so I'll click my test tool and I'll type, what should I write? Let's just write order now. So now I'm done typing. You are not seeing it because it's too small, so let me increase the size. You see, it was too small, that is why you can't see it. So I'll come here, make it the same 24 24. So let me change this. I'll click on this paragraph. I want to align it to the center, and that is what I just did. So So I want to change the color. I'll click here to change the text color, change it to white, and that is done. I'll bring it here. So let me still increase the size. Let me increase it to 30. And make this one 36. So this is this. So for it to, I want to make sure that it's aligning very well. I think it's still okay, but then let me reduce this to 24 34. Okay, then I want to give it a drop down shadow. I'll right click, I'll double click on it, on the layer part, and I'll click on drop down shadow. I'll click on OK. So that is that. I'll be adding another text. It's just for us to add our text. And so this is it. You're going to watch me do that. So for me to add a text here, I'll just click on my text tool, click here, and then I will type. I want to type the name of the brand. Okay. So now I'm done typing the brand name. I want to make it bigger because that is the brand name. It has to be bold for people to see it. So let's make it 60 and so this is okay. Let me place it very well. So now we have so many layers here, and if we don't group them, we might get confused. So because of that, I want us to group everything. So all these three images, we are going to group them together. So you hold your, how you can do that is to hold your shift key and select all of them, all of them, just the three circles. So once you selected the three of them, you click your Ctrl J, that is to group. I'm going to call them, then let's change the name, let's call it circle. So we've changed the name so that we can always access everything at once, so that the here will be more understandable for us. Okay, so the next thing I want us to group is this with the rectangle. Select the both of them and you click your Ctrl J. I'll call this, let me call it main image, just for it to be simple for us. So the vegetables, I'm going to also select it. No, I'll select the, or let me just group the main image with the vegetables and everything around it. So let me go back. So I'll select this, select the vegetables, and I'll Control J. The name I want to give it is main image. So the next thing I'll do now is this particular, this is the name of the brand, so I would like to give it a drop down shadow. You know, I'm so obsessed with giving drop down shadow, so I'll just right click on it, or you double click on it on the layer part, then you click on drop down shadow, and boom, we are good to go. So the next thing we are going to add is delicacy. So I will just quickly type, and I'll be back once I'm done typing. So now that I'm done typing, I want to change the color. I'll come here, I'll change the color to black. I want it to be black color. Click on OK. And also I'll be reducing the size. So let's reduce the size. It's still big, so let's just reduce it to 38. And here should be 0. So I'm also going to give it a drop down shadow. I'll double click on the layer, then click on drop down shadow, and then click on OK. So the next thing we are going to do now is we are going to type something here. So I'll just click on my test tool, click here, and I will be back once I'm done typing. So now I'm done typing, I'm going to reduce the size. First of all, let me change the font. I want to use a different font for it. So the name of the font I'll be using is Photographer Signature. If you don't have it on your system, you can install it. You click on it, Photographer Signature. I've selected the font, and we are going to make it, I'll be reducing the size. Let me click on this bold. I want it to be bold. So, but I want to reduce the size. First of all, let me change the color. Let's change it to white. This is pure white. Let me remove the boldness, and then let me reduce the size, as I said. Let's make it 36. So this 36 is just perfect. So I'm going to drop it here. So the next thing I'll do is to draw a rectangle here, because I want a rectangle here. So I'll just click on the rectangular tool, and I'll draw it here. So but then the color, I want the color to be white. So this is white. No. Yeah, that's the white. So you click on OK. So I want to give it some kind of shaping here. You know, I want to give it some kind of shapings here. So I'll click here. Then I'll come to this place. Make sure you click at the middle here, because if you don't click at the middle, anything you do, for example, just see, anything you do will be affecting the whole side everywhere. So, but that is not what I want. Because of that, I'll just click here, and I'll choose the particular part I want to work on. So I'll just come here. So I'll still increase it. Let me increase it to 200. I think 200 is much. So once I just get it the way I want, I think this is okay. And drop it here. Then I'm going to type. I'll be back once I'm done typing. So now I'm done typing. I'll be changing the font back to Montserrat. That's the name of the font we've been using. I just want us to use two fonts and that is all. I don't want to use so many fonts. It's not good to use more than highest three different fonts. So I'll be going back to the Montserrat, but then Montserrat Bold. Yep, Montserrat Bold. And the next thing is I'll be reducing the size. I think this is too big. Let's make it 24. And here we're going to make it around 24. Is still okay. Yeah, it's perfect. So I'll now bring it in here. You can't see it because it's still white color, so I have to change the color so that you can see it very well. So I'm going to be making it black color, but I think black will be no, I need something to make our work pop, you know. So I'll change the color. Let me use orange. Let's try orange and see how it's going to look like. I think it's beautiful. So let's use a deeper part of orange. A deeper kind of orange. So the next thing I want to do now is to make sure that my work is aligned. And for us to do that, I need to reduce the size a bit. I need to reduce this. So I need to make sure my work is aligned. But before I'll do that, I'll give it a drop down shadow. I'll click here. But then the drop down shadow I want to give it, I don't want it to be black. So let's use the same color. Yep. You see how it's shouting now. It's bold. It's giving, you know. So I'm going to make sure that it doesn't cross my alignment line. No. I have to make sure it doesn't cross that line because it has to be aligned, okay? It has to be well aligned. So this is okay. So the next thing we'll be doing now is to type. We provide other services, which includes we'll type the services that we provide, and I'll be done once I'm done doing that, once I'm done typing. So for me to type that, I'll just click on my test tool, click here. So I'll be right back once I'm done typing. I'm going to align my work to the left. So I'll just click here and I'll align it this way. This is the way I want it to be aligned. And we are going to reduce the size a bit. So you click here and let's reduce the size a bit. Let's make it 21. Let's make here 0. So this time around, I don't want to use bold, so I'm going to be using medium. Yeah, I think this is better. and we'll bring it somewhere here. So the next thing I'll be doing now is to, I want to add some kind of something to number it, so that someone will, once somebody looks at it, the person can know that this was actually numbered. So for me to do that, I'll just click on my test tool, click here. There are so many ways you can do that, whichever way you want to, but I just love using this method because it helps me align very fast. So I'll just click on full stop. I'll just type full stop and I'll click enter, type another full stop, enter. Three. So, and that is it. So I'm going to make it bold. This one will be bold. This is bold, and I'm going to make it bigger. Let's say I'm making it 60. So let me bring it here. Let's see how it looks. And this should be minus 50. I think it's okay like this. It's okay. Once someone looks at it now, the person can know that it's numbered. But then you can still, let me just make it something like 26 or 28. Let me see how 28 is going to look like. No, that's too big. 25 is okay. So this is it. It has helped us do everything so perfect without us having to do so much. But then I have to align it, make sure that it's on this line. You see what all these rulers does now? They help you to align all your work. They help you to align all your work with little or no stress. So you must have to make use of ruler for your work to be properly aligned. So the next thing we are going to do now is, I want to add a contact, how they can call us. Okay, so I'll just use my rectangular tool again and I'll draw a place. Or probably, let me just duplicate this. Let me just come here and I'll click on my Ctrl J, duplicate, and I'll drag it down. Ctrl Z to undo. So this is what I duplicated. I'll bring it down here. But then I want to reduce the size. You can either reduce the size or you bring it. Okay, let me take it more in. So I want it to be on this line. You see what the lines does now? You see? So let me bring it here. I think we should be okay with this. I don't want to align it. I don't want it to be the same line with this. So I just want it this way. So the next thing I'll be doing now is, I'll draw another circle. Because this particular circle, I'll just click. No, not circle. Let's use another rectangular tool and we'll draw. I don't want it joined with this, so I'm going to select this and now click on it and I'll draw my rectangle. This is the rectangle. So I'm going to come here, click here so that it can affect everything. I want it to have a curved end. Okay, I want the end not to be that sharp, so I'll touch it a bit. You see, it's affected everywhere, so I'll bring it down. I'll bring it down a bit. So I'm going to also add, I'll type now. So what should I write there? You can write contact us, colors noun. So let's just use colors noun. Call noun, okay? Call noun. Yeah. So I'm going to use Montserrat bold, and using bold, I'm going to make it, let me just bring it here and see what it looks like. Wow, so let me make it a bit bigger. Now let me just type here and put 26. Oh, Control Z to undo. Control Z, undo. So just to make it bigger, and I want to align it with the rectangle. So I'll hold my shift key and select it together with the rectangle. I'll come here and align them together. You see where I clicked on, because I want two of them to be properly aligned, you know, to fit in properly. So now the next thing is just to add the contact. You can add any contact of your choice. You can add your contact. Let me just type any contact here, and the contact we're going to type is, let's use this particular contact. That's the contact of the person, the client I made this work for. If you love her food, you can, if you love the design, you can actually order for her food anywhere you are. She delivers, and actually her meals are so delicious anyway. So I'm going to make it black. Yep, thank you. So I'll bring it here, but then let me bring it above the rectangle. So now we are done with our design. But you know, each time I keep saying it, whenever you are done with any design, always look around this design, look at it very well, and ask yourself, is there anything that's supposed to be there? Is there anything I have to do that I didn't do, or I'm not doing right? So if when you look at this design, do you think anything is missing on it? Do you think anything is missing? Just tell me at the comment section and I'll be there. So thank you for paying attention to this video. And as you already know how you can save your work and also export it using Photoshop. In case if you don't know that, I'll be making a video on how you can actually save your work and export them without it losing the quality. Or sometimes you design your work and when you export it, it changes a whole lot of things. So I'm going to be making a separate video on that. Thanks for watching my video, and don't forget to subscribe. Subscribing to my channel will be your own little way of encouraging me to do more videos teaching you graphic design using Photoshop for free. Okay, thank you, love you.